48th session, unit 5, electrical instruments and measurements. In this session, we'll be studying cathode ray oscilloscope. The learning objective of the 48th session is to understand the principle, construction and working of cathode ray oscilloscope. The basic principle behind the working of cathode ray oscilloscope. It is based on the fact that an electron beam is deflected by an electric and magnetic field, and a bright spot is produced when electric beam strikes the fluorescent screen. The CRO is an instrument which converts the electrical signals into visual signals. And here we have the block diagram of cathode ray oscilloscope. This block diagram has many blocks like the vertical amplifier, trigger circuit, time based generator, delay line, the horizontal amplifier and the high voltage supply and low voltage supply, and the most important of all, this is the cathode ray tube, which is also called as the heart of the CRO. It is nothing but a evacuated glass envelope which consists of electron gun at the one end, and in between you have the vertical and horizontal plates, and at the end of the tube there is a fluorescent screen, and we shall discuss in detail about these blocks. So these are the main blocks or the components of the CRO: vertical amplifier, delay line, horizontal amplifier, time based generator, trigger circuit, power supply and CRT. The function of each block of CRO is mentioned below. First one, the vertical amplifier. It amplifies the input signal which is to be displayed on the screen of the CRT. The basic function of the amplifier is to amplify, meaning to increase the strength of the input signal. That is, for example, if the input signal is 1 millivolt, it will increase its voltage to 1 volt. Next, the delay line. It provides some amount of delay to the signal, which is obtained at the output of the vertical amplifier. This delayed signal is then applied to vertical deflection plates of cathode ray tube. The trigger circuit. It produces a triggering signal in order to synchronize both horizontal and vertical deflection of electron beam. The basic function is to synchronize both horizontal as well as vertical deflection of electron beam. Next, the time based generator. It produces a sawtooth signal which is useful for horizontal deflection of electron beam. Next, the horizontal amplifier. The main basic function of this amplifier is almost the same as the vertical amplifier, but it amplifies the sawtooth signal and then connects it to the horizontal deflection plates of the cathode ray tube. The power supply. It produces both high and low voltages. The negative high voltage and the positive low voltage are applied to the cathode ray tube and the other circuits respectively. Cathode ray tube, which is also called as the heart of cathode ray oscilloscope. It is the main important block of the CRO and mainly consists of three components, namely first one electron gun, second the reflection system, the third one is fluorescent screen. And on the screen we can see the block diagram of CRT. The left end of the CRT, there is an electron gun which consists of cathode, the filament, control grid, focusing anode and the accelerating anode. Onto the right end of the CRT, there is a fluorescent screen which is usually coated with phosphor or zinc sulfide. And between two ends, in the middle, there is a deflection system which consists of vertical and horizontal plates. And we shall discuss in detail the function of each component. The electron gun, in which the filament is connected to low voltage and it is responsible for heating the cathode. And this cathode is coated with a layer of barium oxide onto the one end, and upon being sufficiently heated by the filament, this cathode emits the electrons. And the control grid is entirely made from nickel, which is usually kept at negative potential and helps to control the intensity of the electron beam. Pre-accelerating anode. There is no mention of this in the block diagram, but it is just before the focusing anode. Its main function is to provide acceleration to the electron beam just before entering the focusing anode. The focusing anode, it helps in aligning the incoming electron beam. And then the accelerating anode, it is connected to a common positive potential of 1500 volts. And its function is to again accelerate the newly aligned electron beam. After the electron gun, there is a deflection system and fluorescent screen. Deflection system consists of vertical and horizontal deflection plates. The accelerated electron beam is made to pass through vertical and horizontal deflection plates. And these plates provide horizontal and vertical direction to the accelerated electron beam. And finally, when the deflected beam strikes the fluorescent screen, we observe a very bright spot. Now the fluorescent screen, the inner side or the inner part of the screen is coated with phosphor or zinc sulfide. When the electrons strike the screen, the material fluoresces and becomes luminous or glows. This enables a bright spot to appear wherever an electron beam strikes the screen. We know that accelerated electron have energy associated with it because of its mass and velocity. So therefore, when these high energy electrons strike the screen, the fluorescent screen coated with zinc sulfide converts the kinetic energy of the electrons into light energy. And we observe a bright spot on the screen. This is how CRO converts the electrical input signal into a visual signal. The material or the content used for the presentation is taken from Electricity and Magnetism book written by Dr. K.K. Tiwari, and the block diagram of CRO is taken from this website.